united with one mind to enjoy Christian fellowship. Today's Bible verse is taken from Philippians chapter 2 verses 1 to 11. In this passage, a description through imitating Christ's humility and how to be united with one mind to enjoy Christian fellowship is addressed by St. Paul to Philippians. Paul encouraged the people to follow fellowship with Holy Spirit, kindness and compassion for one another. I would like to address three key points today with reference to this passage: imitating Christ's humility, second as united community, and third as power of a change. Imitating Christ's humility. Humility comes from the Latin word humilis, meaning quality of being humble. Genesis chapter 1, 26 to 31 says, God created man in his own image and made us as a keeper of creation. Ephesians 1, 5 says, predestined us to be adopted as his sons through Jesus Christ. So we are chosen people. Thus we are messengers of God, directing the objectives for the achievement of likeness of God. We get sanctified with observing ordinance, believing in Bible, prayer, trust, hope and actions that we endure daily. Verses 7, 8 and 9 says, the life of Jesus is an example of servanthood, enduring humiliation and served the ministry. His selflessness in love promoted redemption, a sacrificial life to gain the glory of God. Matthew 20, 28 says, just as the Son of Man came not to be served but to serve, he taught the true mission through serving others. Paul directs us to have a humble attitude to others by sharing love and being one in soul and mind than a selfish desire. Point 2. United community. As given in Acts chapter 8, 26 to 39, a meaningful conversation between eunuch and Philip was a mark of his personal relationship with God, and baptism of eunuch shows a sacramental relationship. The significance of this act is cleansing for sin theologically and incorporation into the fellowship of those who have experienced blessings. Therefore, in Christian mission, co-journey and co-sacramental relationship through submission, confession and baptism is a beautiful embodiment for salvation. In our day-to-day life, do we take a co-journey with others to have a meaningful conversation? It was a tough mission given by God for Elijah in barren land, yet God became the provider of food and water. It was a challenge to be faced and Elijah submitted himself. Here is a presence of God in a different way as he submitted himself before God. Therefore, we should submit or surrender up to overcome the challenges in our life. A church rooted in an integrity is a phenomenon of Christianity. A prayerful family devoted in caring and sharing were prominent qualities of early churches before the democratic setup as we see today. Despite of inequalities and conspiracies, today the leaders have a great difficulty to find appropriate decisions on complaints and problems. Jealousy destroys brotherhood in society, as Bible says, the story of Cain and Abel. As a church, we must be accountable for our responsibilities and should be answerable for the accounts written in heaven. Justice is established only through effective leadership. We must uphold all our spiritual leaders in our prayers in order to direct us in the sense of brotherhood in Christ than rivalry. Point 3. Power of a change. In modern societies, as we see people around living with their selfish life, we as Christians often fails to confront issues of injustice and hatred. In the midst of these difficulties, shall we make a difference through a focused mission by meaningful co-journey and conversation? How is it races, cultures, languages and thoughts together in Christian mission? John 17:23 is an answer: to love one another in order to find unity in diversity. We must motivate each other through love and compassion. It will promote holy spiritual relationship. Troubles and difficulties often come across in our day-to-day life. Acts 27:25, Paul's faith and hope encouraged the fellow men when they were in the sea with difficult storm, as nearer to the lost hope of survival. As Christians, we must convey our hope and faith in God when difficulties arise, and eventually must encourage others too. Paul prompts us to follow godliness and good deeds to attract the other person to understand our Savior. Forgiveness is another quality to bridge distances in relationships. In Christian mission, Genesis 45, 1-15 shows how closely Joseph overcame the injustice done by his brothers and the reunion because of his nature forgiveness. Luke 23, 34 says, Jesus forgives men while he was in pain on the cross. We must pray that we should get the mind of Joseph to grow in maturity and grace of God when there is bitterness around. Being sinners, we are blessed in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ as we are leading our Christian community in the light of faith, love, peace and hope. Let our prayer be, Lord, help me to hear your call and be an active participant in your vineyard. Help me to lead others in humiliation, unity and love. O Lord, give us the spirit of humility and be free from all prejudices. Amen.